Dr. Cheryl Threadgold has a PhD in theatre history. She has a Medal of the Order of Australia for her contribution to the arts community. She's worked for ABC Television and Radio 3AW. She's a playwright, she's a performer, she's a director, and she's a choreographer. And she's an author, and most recently, she's written and released In the Name of Theatre, the history, culture, and voices of amateur theatre in Victoria. Welcome, Cheryl.
Thank you very much, Andrew.
Cheryl, In the Name of Theatre, congratulations on a successful launch and on a very successful book.
Oh, thanks very much, Andrew. Look, it was just something that needed to be done. In 2007, I actually started. I did one subject with Open Universities Australia because I wanted to learn more about Greek mythology for my honorary reviewing with the Melbourne Observer. I do theatre writing, and I still do now. I coordinate the review team and still write. And quite a few plays at that time were associated with Greek mythology. And so I did that one subject and really enjoyed it so much. I did another and another. And I ended up doing 24 for a Bachelor of Arts, majoring in communication and English literature and composition. And I thought, well, look, it's probably sensible to extend one's writing potential to the full limit. And so I did a Master's of Art Writing. And somebody then suggested, what about a PhD? And, well, oh, I don't know, gosh. And then I thought this could be the perfect opportunity to research amateur theatre in Victoria with an academic underpinning and hopefully at the end of the thesis, a book could be done. And so that was the actual path that I undertook to do In the Name of Theatre. And the PhD was finished last year. I graduated last year. I thought, no, the book's got to be done. You know, I wanted to follow this through. If you want something done, you do it yourself. So, look, I self-published, and all the profits go to the Victorian Drama League and the Music Theatre Guild of Victoria. And it's got a really nice thing about it, because a nice sense of goodwill. So this is the book. And that great cover was designed by Luke Harris. I'd envisaged a conservative cover with an old theatre on the front and a new one on the back. And Luke asked for some images of other theatres. And the next thing he says, this fabulous merging of theatricality with history. And I knew he nailed it, you know, and I was so grateful. Frank Van Straten, the well-known theatre historian in Australia, he very kindly wrote the foreword. A long overdue and loving tribute to the thousands of dedicated people who have devoted their talents and their time to helping people like me experience that special form of magic in the name of theatre.
Cheryl, they're beautiful words, and I was lucky enough to attend the online launch a few days ago, and some of the other words that were used to describe the book and to describe you was inspirational, beautiful, and an incredibly important record of amateur theatre in Victoria. So congratulations for all that praise. It's very well deserved.
I appreciated it very much. I was very fortunate to have, apart from having fabulous university supervisors, and I was also very fortunate to have the president of the Victorian Drama League, Bruce Cochran, and the president of the Music Theatre Guild of Victoria, Ange Kai, as my communicators that I could just liaise with and say, oh, something's gone wrong or something's gone right. And they were just so lovely to have them there for this year while the book has been developed. Was such a marvellous support. And there are 130 odd stories from theatre companies. Some have been written by the theatre companies themselves, others were updated from my research. So it's a wonderful collective project, you know, full of all these lovely positive vibes. The thing is, Andrew, that the cover has been, the cover art is donated also to the BDL and Music Theatre Guild of Victoria for others to build on in the future. Now, there can be future volumes on other topics using this, you know, volume one, volume two. And there's plenty of scope for using this as a foundation to build on in the future.
You've spoken to a lot of people at a lot of theatre companies. What do you think makes for a successful amateur theatre?
They have to have that passion, which all unpaid theatre makers do. And I know all theatre makers, whether they're professional or independent or unpaid, they all have the passion. They're collaborating and sharing energies of fellow theatre makers and others who have, you know, various skills and talents. Now, in saying that, that's what you do need. But I remember Grand Alley from Clock Musical Theatre, which is a very successful musical theatre company in Victoria. Grant said that art, a theatre should be a business as well as art. And so while we're having this wonderful creative experience and bringing art and culture to the communities, the theatre company really needs to be run as a business within reason, you know, not like a huge corporation, depending on the size of the company, within the company's means to make sure that they're looking ahead as to what finances are going to be needed to start off with the next show and not overspending beyond their means. And that takes a bit of skill, you know, and I think this could be the reason in some areas over the years that some theatre companies might have closed down because financially you could get into a pickle if, you know, you haven't sold enough seats and you haven't got enough money to pay off what you've spent on this show, and you've certainly got no money to pay for the next show. And you usually have to, as you know, spend money on licensing rights beforehand. So you need to put some money aside for that. So look, to make a good amateur theatre company, you've got to have people to start off with. And I mean, people are what make a theatre company. And I mentioned at the launch that in my research, it was interesting that the strengths, the top of the strengths when I interviewed people about their perceived strengths was volunteers. And also the top of weaknesses. The top weakness was volunteers as well, which of course is what people are all about. They have their idiosyncrasies and their strengths. And that's what makes up a theatre company. But on top of that, there has to be the sharing of the skills and the expertise and the talent, and the company has to be run efficiently and well. And it also has to have a good presence in the community. You know, the local people need to be able to have a sense, I believe, a sense of ownership. This is our company, particularly in smaller towns.
Amateur theatre seems to have a bit of a stigma to it. A lot of people prefer to use the term community theatre. What are your thoughts?
I think community theatre sounds much better, Andrew, but unfortunately for the purpose of my project, it's not technically accurate to describe the unpaid theatre maker. And I didn't know this when I started my studies in 2015, and I was giving a talk at a university conference, and the lady stood up at the end and she said, look, excuse me, you're not talking about community theatre, you're talking about amateur theatre. And she introduced herself as a community theatre arts practitioner who gets paid to go out into communities, to work with communities on a project about their community. And of course I said, oh, but I'm talking about theatre in communities, by communities, for communities. And she said, yes, but ours is about communities. And so I went home and did a bit of research, and she was right. And I thought, the theatre maker doesn't care. Who cares what the name of your overarching category is? You're doing this for passion and in the name of theatre, because that is the most important thing.
Cheryl, how can people buy the book?
Probably the easiest way, Andrew, is via the website inthenameoftheatre.com.au. It's $49.50, and that includes free postage anywhere in Australia.
Congratulations on a successful book launch. Congratulations on selling out the first print run, and congratulations for doing yet another thing in support of and in the name of community theatre.
Thanks very much, Andrew.